Hello everyone, this is Dude Blender, and let's jump right in. We're going to explain each operation in the vector math node and visually show it in this setup. If you want to watch the math node video first before this one, the link is in the description. This will be our main window, and these are orthographic views, xy, yz, and zx. This way you can easily see the exact values of each operation. The grid shows increments of 1, 5, and 10. The result of the operation will always be shown in red, while the inputs will be blue, aqua, and purple. I'll also try whenever possible to stay in the first octant, where all the values are positive, to keep it simple. Now, a few things to know beforehand so that we're all on the same page.
The sum of the square roots of any two sides of an isosceles triangle is equal to the square root of the remaining side.
So what's a vector? A vector is just a collection of three numbers that provide information, usually a location or a rotation in a 3D space. We represent vectors by drawing a line from the origin to the coordinates specified in the vector, always in XYZ format. Note that the origin of the vector does not necessarily have to be the world origin, and for certain applications, we'll move some of the vectors around. Vectors contain two important pieces of information: the magnitude, which is how long the vector is, and it's always a positive number, and the direction. An example you remember from your physics class is that speed is a value that we call scalar, meaning it does not specify the direction, while velocity is vectorial, so it provides a magnitude, how fast the object is moving, and also the direction that the object is moving towards. Also note that in Blender, connectors are blue if they receive or output vectors, and they are gray if they receive or output floats. So we could say blue is vectorial and gray is scalar. And finally, we'll call the inputs A and B if there's no specific label. Now let's get into the node. Add adds up both vectors by adding each of the corresponding dimensions, so x plus x, y plus y, z plus z. You can think of this operation as putting one of the vectors at the end of the other one. Subtract does the opposite. This would be like putting the end of B at the end of A. Or you could say you're adding the negative vector. Multiply multiplies the values of each corresponding dimension. You can see this in the orthographic views. So 2 times 3 equals 6. 3 times 5 equals 15. And 4 times 5 equals 20. In the same way, divides the values by each corresponding dimension, A divided by B. And just to show one example, 10 divided by 5 equals 2. Multiply add multiplies the vector times the multiplier in the way we saw before, and then adds the addend. We can see that 2 times 4 equals 8, plus 1 equals 9, which we can see here, and 3 times 2 equals 6, plus 2 equals 8. We can see in the y direction it's an 8. Cross product outputs a vector that is perpendicular to both input vectors, with the magnitude being equal to, and bear with me for a second, the area of the parallelogram formed by both vectors. This will be crystal clear in a second. So if these two vectors formed a plane, then the result will be perpendicular to that plane. This is easier to see when both inputs are on one of these planes. If we zero z on both inputs, now both of the input vectors are sitting on the green plane, and that means that the cross product should go directly up or down, since those are the two vectors that would be perpendicular to this green plane. And you might be wondering, then how do we know what direction the result will be, since both vectors, positive or negative, would be perpendicular to both inputs? Engineers use something that's called the right-hand rule. You put your fingers like this, with the index pointing towards the A vector, here the blue one, and the middle finger towards the second vector. Here it is the aqua. The thumb will point towards the direction of the cross product, and we can see that it in fact goes in that way. Now for the magnitude, it's this area. We say parallelogram as the shape might be a square, a rectangle, a rhomboid, or a rhombus. And so the term parallelogram encompasses all of those shapes. That's why we use that fancy word. Now, if both vectors point exactly towards the same direction or away from each other, then you'll see that the magnitude is zero because there is no area in this shape, as it's just a line. But as soon as we break that line, we can see that the magnitude changes, as there is now some area in this parallelogram. Project projects the A vector onto the B vector. The resulting vector will fall along an infinite line defined by the direction of B. You'll see that the resulting vector is not bound by the length of B, so it can go beyond B in either direction, but it will always fall on the axis created by that vector. Reflect reflects the vector A around the normal B. So if B is a normal, then we can create a plane that has that normal. And then the result is the reflection of A around this plane that is defined by the normal B. You can also understand this as A being the incident vector, and then the result is the vector that will be reflected on this plane. Refract refracts the vector A around the normal B, considering the index of refraction. You can see that there's a slightly different angle between the incident vector and the result based on the index of refraction. And in the same way as before, you can think about the A vector as the incident vector and the result as the refracted ray around this plane. Phase forward is kind of a mess how this is written, but this is how I understand it. Exactly. So if we take the reference as the normal of a plane and we add this plane, we can see what's happening. So what it actually does is it returns the input vector whenever the incident is pointing towards the opposite side of the plane than the reference, and returns the negative of the input vector whenever the incident is pointing towards the same side of the plane than the reference. So as soon as the incident crosses the plane, then the operation will just return the input vector. You cannot see it here because it's on the same place, but if I move the input a little bit, you'll see that it's there. Dot product does not return a vector, it just returns a float number equal to multiplying the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the cosine of the angle between them. In this cosine chart, you'll see that if the angle is higher than 90 and lower than 270 degrees, then the result is negative. If it's exactly 90 or 270, the result is zero. And otherwise, it is positive. So back in Blender, we can see that the result is positive as long as both vectors remain within 90 degrees of each other in any direction. But as soon as we break those 90 degrees, then the result becomes negative. If this sounds familiar to phase forward, it's because they use the exact same math. Distance also returns a float equal to the distance between both vectors. Length returns a float equal to the length or the magnitude of the vector. Note that the magnitude has no sign, so it will always be a positive number. Scale multiplies the magnitude of vector times scale while keeping the direction equal. Normalize returns a vector with the same direction, but always with a magnitude of 1. Absolute returns a vector with all positive dimensions, so whatever the input, the output will always fall in the first octant. Minimum returns a vector with each dimension being the minimum between the two vectors. So X will be the minimum of both, Z will be the minimum of both, and Y will be the minimum of both. Maximum does the opposite and returns a vector that has each dimension being the maximum between both vectors. Floor rounds down each dimension towards the next integer. Seal rounds up each dimension of the vector towards the next integer. Fraction removes the integer part of each dimension, leaving only the fraction part. Modulo returns a vector with a modulo operation of each dimension. Here's an excerpt from the math video about the modulo operation. Modulo returns the remainder of the division. For example, 11 divided by 3 can also be written as 3 and 2 thirds. This is a modulo. You can also input fractional numbers. For example, 9.5 modulo 3.5 could be something like 2 and 2.5 3/5. So the modulo would be 2.5. Wrap will wrap each dimension around the minimum and maximum vectors. Snap rounds down each dimension to the next multiple defined by increment. Sine returns a vector with each dimension being the sine of the corresponding input dimension. Note that it will take these as radians and not as degrees. Cosine is the same but with the cosine, and tangent is also the same but with the tangent. That's it for today. Drop a like, comment, and subscribe if you like the video, and connect with me on TikTok and Instagram with the handle @dude_blender. I'm Dude Blender. Happy blending.